Nah, I'm not feeling it. I'm not feeling it. The hell was that? Hello? Like you've seen a ghost. All I see right now is a grown-ass man wearing clown shit on his face in my house. Kinda like looking in the mirror, hmm? Alright, look, give me one reason why I shouldn't call the cops on you right now. How about a couple of jokes, hmm?
What?
Okay. This one should be easy for you. What's red and bad for your teeth?
What?
A brick in the face. That one's not so good, really. You have to set the tone of any routine, of any gag that tests the audience's receptiveness to your individual style. Alright, here's the second one. And my pud loved this one. So there's a man on death row. He asked the guard, what's life after death like? And the guard says, well, I don't know, but the bit before that might be a shock.
Oh boy.
Okay, that one was a warm-up. A warm-up to my favorite joke of all time. But I don't know if you'll like it, really. It's not really your type of humor. But since you're my friend now.
We ain't friends, I don't even know you.
Acquaintances. What do you say?
Right. How about I go back in my room, go back to doing my music, and pretend like this didn't just happen?
How about I cut your legs and arms off, hmm? So what do you say? That's my pal. See, there were these two guys. And they lived in a lunatic asylum, okay? And one night they decide that they don't like living in an asylum anymore. So they decided to go and escape. So they get up onto a roof, and they're across this narrow gap, if you will. They see the rooftops of the town stretching out, stretching away to freedom. Freedom. Now, the first guy, he jumps across with no problem at all. But his friend
didn't dare make the leap, you see.
You see, he's afraid of falling. So the first guy says, hey, I have my flashlight with me. So I'll shine it across the gap between buildings. You can walk along the beam and join me. But then the second guy just shakes his head. He says, what do you think I am, crazy? You just turned it off and I was halfway across.
Ha ha ha.
That's my favorite joke. My favorite joke.
Look, just shut up with all the magic tricks and your jokes. What's the point of all this?
All right, look. You and I are a lot alike.
No, compared to you, I am completely normal.
Normal? Does anyone know what normal truly means? You know, I used to be just like you. I used to have friends just like you. I used to have family just like you. And I had a father.
Don't go there!
As I was saying, I used to try to please them and live up to their standards and blend into society. I used to have a strong heart, but trust me, hang around me long enough and you'll find yourself realizing that the strongest hearts have the most scars. And speaking of which, you wanna know how I got mine?
Nah, I'm good. I don't need to hear any more imaginary stories from a freak.
Don't talk like you're them. You're not! Even if you'd like to be, to them, you're just a freak. Like me, they need you right now. But when they don't, they'll cast you out. Like a leopard.
No, I'm not, and no, they won't. All right, look, you don't know a damn thing about me.
I know exactly who you are. And you know exactly who I am. And I know the one thing that kills you every single day of your life that no one else knows.
And what's that?
I know what happened at the Gotham City Park. And I know why you're afraid to go out at night. The Batman. See, Batman took someone very near and dear away from you. And I know it eats away at you day. Day after day. And you wanna know what else happened last year? See, last year, it was me and my puddin'. And her name was Harley Quinn. And her and I, we were inseparable. We took the soul of Gotham and we ran with it, with only a knife and a bat in our hands. In a way, she was fearless and crazier than me. But then the Batman took her away from me. So, you and I have both lost somebody thanks to the Batman. And I know deep down inside, you want vengeance. So I only have one question.
Don't even finish that. What happened between her has nothing to do with the Batman. Mm-hmm. I don't want vengeance because there's nothing to be vengeful about.
That's what you're trying to convince yourself in your head. And it's okay. I know you're afraid.
I am not afraid.
People fear what they don't understand. They tried to label me as a freak, anarchist, or villain. A sex symbol.
At least that's what she called me sometimes.
And I know they called you a lot of things too. They tried to label you unhinged, unstable, psychotic. And I know you're not. I know you're not any of those things. I know who you really are.
No, you don't. Look, I know what you're trying to do. You're trying to brainwash me into playing your little games, and you know what? I ain't doing it.
You're a stubborn one, aren't you? Well, since I still have you here, I have one last, very important question that I'd like to ask you.
Go ahead, hear me.
Which side of history would you like to be on? The one with rules, or the one without rules? The only sensible way to live in this world is without rules. And tonight, you're gonna break your one rule. So what's your answer?
No.
No!
No.
No. You don't wanna keep fighting the voices.
They'll never go away no matter how much you beg them to stop. They're gonna live rent-free in your head for the rest of your life until you eventually embrace the darkness that's been building up inside of you for years. That's what I did. And look at how well I've turned out.
Shut up!
You're only making it harder on yourself. Come on, take it.
I know you want to.
Shut up! You have nothing, nothing to threaten me with. Nothing to do with all your strengths. I know it kills you. In fact, I know it kills you so much that you want to take your hands and push them into your skull and smash your brain into a million pieces so you can have 5 seconds of peace without the voices talking to you. But the voices, they'll never stop. Not until you do what you have to do in order to survive.
I said,
wait, wait. Let me tell you one last story before we part ways. You know what I did with those voices? I stopped fighting the voices. And I started listening to them. And they took my crooked little world and turned it into something so beautiful.
Why the fuck are you doing this to me?
You see, they broke you, but he can put you back together.
Who's he?
Oh. You don't know who he is. Well, don't worry. You'll meet him very, very soon. But you won't have to if you take this. Give a man a mask, and he will become his true self.
Alright, for Harley, I think you gotta, like, smudge this. So it's, like... Can I, like, curve it up into a Joker? And, like... Alright. Do I look like Harley? No, I don't. Not yet. I'm really bad at this. Oh man, my stepmom never let me wear makeup until like sophomore year in high school, I think. Well, now I just look crazy. I guess that's the whole point. So, good luck on that. So, once the video's all edited, we'll probably put it up so you can all see how much of a failure it is. So, that's it. Bye, guys.